Hey, what's up? It's Austin from Make Pop Music and Austin Hall Audio, and I am here to show you around our brand new drum kit, Sour Candy. Sour Candy is our first full-velocity multi-sample drum kit, and we could not be more excited. We've brought in the extraordinary Tomas Shannon to bring you the most versatile and highest quality samples we could possibly imagine. Sour Candy is a full-velocity multi-sample drum kit with a kick, two snares, claps, rim hits, three toms, tambourines, hi-hats, three crashes, and a ride. We also included over 130 organic loops, including cymbal loops, tambourine loops, shell loops, and fills, that are all inspired by drum sounds found throughout modern punk-influenced pop records. We've also worked really hard on giving you all of the file formats you could want, so within this pack, you'll find a Kontakt instrument for Kontakt 6, you'll find a Groove Agent instrument for Groove Agent SC5, you'll find an Ableton Rack kit for Ableton users, you have a Logic Sampler kit for Logic users, we have Trigger 2 TCI files if you like doing your drum replacement later in a mix, and we've included all of the one-shots and loops as drag-and-drop versions of themselves. In addition to over 350 samples and loops and 6 kit variations, we're giving you an exclusive video series to show you how to use each kit version, tips on making your drum sound more realistic, and easy ways to use this pack within any workflow. Now that we've talked about Sour Candy, let's actually explore so I can show you around some of the different kit versions and you can hear this thing in action. Okay, now we have the kit pulled up. This is what the Kontakt interface looks like. We'll mess around with the Kontakt instrument first, and then I'll show you some of the other variations. So let's go ahead and take a listen to what this kit sounds like. So there we go, that's what the kit sounds like once it's loaded up. We haven't adjusted anything in this Kontakt instrument. Now let's go ahead and actually explore the Kontakt instrument since you've heard what the kit sounds like, and I'll show you what all we've included in this version and then talk about some of the other versions as well. This does work in Kontakt 6, the full version, so if you are using only the Kontakt player, you might want to opt for a different kit version that we'll talk about in just a little bit. But let's explore this. So you can see that we've built in three different effects right here. We have saturation, reverb, and low pass filter. On the home screen, these will control the entire drum mix, and you can either drive them up or down. You can also turn them on or off by clicking a button right here, or you can reset them by control clicking or command clicking on Mac. So here's what it sounds like once we kind of mess with some of these. I'll show you while the whole kit plays. Like I said too, if you drive them up, you can turn them on and off, so I'll show you that. So that's how you can control those kind of master effects over the entire kit. However, if you want to open up the mixer window, which is my favorite part, you can just click on either one of those rainbow icons, and you can see right here that now we have a mixer window with different lanes for kick, snare, clap, toms, hats, cymbals, tambourines, and loops. So each different layer has a pan knob, a saturation knob, a reverb knob, and a volume fader, and then you've also got your output controls right here. So you can multi-out this kit if you want to, and then it's really, really nice having the individual saturation and reverb controls right here. One thing to keep in mind if you're using the Kontakt kit and you do want to control the saturation and reverb independently is make sure that you've left them on your home screen. If you have them grayed out like this, it will control the master reverb and the master saturation, which will make these not responsive. So just make sure that those are on for the master kit, and then you can do these all to taste. This is all pretty self-explanatory. There's nothing too insane going on here. I do want to go ahead and talk about the loops folder because this is something that I am very, very excited about. So as I said before, we do have different loop variations provided with the kit. We have four tempos. We have 145, 155, 165, and 175. And we do have the loops divided between cymbal loops, shell loops, and fills. So you can kind of mix and match loops as we go. So if you're playing to one of these tempos in Kontakt, we've actually programmed a little loop menu down here. You'll see it starting right here. And you can play through any of the pink keys, and as you swap up, it's going to change what you're playing. So between having the individual lanes for every kit piece in the mixer window and having these loops that you can sort through and pop up to different tempos and kind of control with key switches over here, I think that this is a really, really cool way to use this. One thing to keep in mind is that all of the different kit versions will be velocity sensitive, but they all have their own algorithms and work in slightly different ways. And I tend to find that the Kontakt one is just the most true to form and it's the easiest to work with. With that said, here are some of the samples that we've included just so you can hear what the different velocities sound like. Now that you've heard some of those in solo, let's go ahead and hear how this kit sounds if we pull down some velocities and play it at a really low velocity level. Now let's compare that to the full velocity over here. We worked really hard on making this kit feel dynamic and realistic, so we know not everybody has Kontakt 6. However, we didn't want that to limit you while you're playing with this kit, so let's go ahead and talk about some of the other different versions that we have. We'll take a look at the Groove Agent kit since I am in Cubase. This is something that comes stock with most Cubase licenses, so let's go ahead and take a listen to this. Let's take a look at how you can use something like Trigger to re-trigger your samples. So right now, we just have a pretty generic pop kick. Now let's say you want to take a kick in your mix and turn it into the Sour Candy kit. If you have Trigger 2, it's super easy. We have a video that shows you exactly how to load everything into your browser. So let's just take this right here, and since it's a kick, I'll just drag the kick right here, and you can hear how this kick now becomes a Sour Candy piece. And all of the Trigger TCI files are also velocity sensitive. You can really drag in anything. Since it's a kick, I just put in a kick, but let's go ahead and drag the snare in so you can hear that. Now we do have an Ableton Rack kit, but since I am not an Ableton user, I'm not gonna cover this too much in that walkthrough. However, if you do download this kit, we do have an Ableton Rack video that comes with it, so you can see how to install it, how to utilize it, how to navigate it, and you can kind of hear that in use. Same thing with a Logic kit. Since I am not in Logic, I can't cover that in too much detail in this walkthrough, but once again, we do have a video covering how to install that, how to utilize that in Logic, how to load the Logic sampler and make that communicate with Logic Drummer, and that's all covered and it's included in the kit for free. Let's go ahead and talk about one of my favorite parts of this kit, and that is the loops that we've included. So we've included over 130 different loops, and we've done that in four different tempos, 145, 155, 165, and 175. And every tempo has its own little vibe, but what we did is we tracked the cymbals separately from the shells, and we've tracked the drum loops separately from the drum fills, and then we have tambourine loops and clap loops that you can use as little toppers. So I want to show you an example of what it sounds like to kind of mix and match shell pieces, just so you can hear how dynamic and how different you can make your drum production just by dragging in and mixing and matching some of these loops. So you'll see right here, they will change names. And as soon as they change names, that means it's a different loop. Let's go ahead and listen to an example. So you can hear as we swap loops, we get totally different vibes and different feels, but since this is separated, it gives us a ton of control, and these are really, really nice things to just drag in your kit as you are programming a song. If you prefer to not use one of the kit versions and you're a big fan of dragging and dropping samples, we also have that covered. We have a samples folder within your kit where you can see you have your loops and your cymbal loops. However, there is a one-shots folder. We have that separated between drums, which are going to be all of the shells, and cymbals. And within each of that, you can see the folders right here, so you can go ahead and open that, see all of the different velocity hits and versions of each different kit piece, and you can drag and drop those as you want. And since we've included all of the different velocity hits for the one-shots, you can still get a really, really realistic program drum just by dragging and dropping them in your grid and swapping some of those different velocity layers for another piece. Like we've been talking about throughout this video, there is a series of instructional videos included. You'll find a PDF in your download, and you can just click any of these hyperlinks on this and watch the video for whatever topic you want. And we have also included a detailed manual that talks about how to install each kit version. It talks about the key mapping, it talks about some tips and tricks, and goes over some common troubleshooting issues. So we did go ahead and include a full manual and a full video series, so all of the support should be there. But of course, if you have any other issues or questions, shoot an email over to support@makepopmusic.com. This kit is on makepopmusic.com, so you can go check that out right now. The kit is $40, and that includes all different kit versions and all of the loops and all of the extra instructional videos and everything like that. Thank you so much for sitting through this. We hope that you enjoy this kit. Let us know if you have any questions, and until next time, much love, everyone. Peace.